Hi, I'm Les with Ross Video. Today I'm going to talk to you about our Acuity production switchers. So Acuity is our top-of-the-line flagship switchers. It comes in two different frame sizes and six different panel sizes. All of these MEs are laid out in a nice traditional manner with our sources, our transition areas, our keyer controls, and our memory systems. Now, one of the big features of Acuity is our custom control macros. These allow me to create timelineable events that with a single button press will include my devices, my cameras, all of my elements to create a repeatable event. Now, one thing that we do really well is I can run multiple macros simultaneously. Now, this allows me to be doing effects and wipes while at the same time still triggering other graphics and other elements. So when I tie that all together, it gives me as an operator the ability to have a consistent, predetermined show that every time I do these things, I'll get the same result. Now, with Acuity, we've taken it and we've increased all of its power. Acuity is an 8-keyer, fully functioned in 1080p, with 16 channels of 2D DVE standard and 4 media stores with 8 gigabytes of RAM cache. So every time we add an ME into the Acuity system, we gain more horsepower, more abilities, and more control. And with our new multi-feed system with split ME, I have 8 programmable outputs out of every single ME. This gives me the power to take those keyers and those elements and create little mini MEs, split it up, get the task done that I need. These are things that you just can't do with other switchers. So it's very simple to just put these two keys on a different background, these two keys on a different background, and create all the elements that I need. So now that we've talked a little bit about how the ME architecture works, when we go into a 4K mode, which is very important these days, it requires the quad linking of the resources. Now what's nice is because I have 8 MEs and I can split those MEs, we're the only production switcher that is going to give you a 4ME, 4-keyer in a 4K production. And by linking those together, it's a seamless workflow. As a TD, I just move along the buttons, and underneath, the system architecture is going to handle that splitting of it for you. So you don't have to think about how to direct it and how to do bus linking. You just press the buttons, and we'll take care of the rest. Inside of our Acuity production switchers, we've always had and we introduced multi-viewing. Now, what we've launched is the new input-based multi-viewers. This is on our multi-input processing card. So the multi-processing input card consists of the same 20 inputs. However, there is always a hidden bus. And that bus now will bring a 20-input multi-viewer dedicated on the input card back into the system matrix. This allows you to even re-enter that multi-viewer into your other system-based multi-viewers. All 120 inputs can be monitored simultaneously while still having the additional system-based multi-viewers. On top of that, the multi-processing input card gives me 8 frame sinks, allowing me to assign those to any of those inputs, 4 level B to level A converters to incorporate any 1080p level B source in with the level A system, and 20 color correctors and proc amps, allowing it all to be done on the input stage. Now, when I look at my multi-viewers, I can have any arrangement and configuration. Those multi-viewers on the input card allow one head with all 20 windows. All tally, source, and mnemonics automatically follow along with these systems. So if I go into a multi-viewer and I change the layout and I change a source, that source is going to follow along, and all of the information, including tally and naming, will follow with it. So this is a big advantage in that when I load a new show file, not only do I get all of my effects, all of my switcher controls, but it relays out that monitor wall automatically for me. You can even incorporate changes to the multi-viewer on the fly through the custom control macro system. So that way, when I go to a different segment of my show, the multi-viewer is also going to change to put the most pertinent information right in front of my face, so I don't have to look across the room to see it on a small window. So the multi-viewing ability built right into the switcher and now on our input is a huge, huge advantage for the Acuity production switcher. So when we look at the frame chassis, this is our 8RU chassis. All system boards, DVEs, power supplies, everything for this 8ME switcher all resides in this very compact 8RU chassis. All 120 inputs and 60 outputs are all readily available in a mid-plane design. One of the new features beyond all of these multi-processing inputs is now we're launching our new Aspen Ready I/O boards. These Aspen Ready I/O boards can populate every single slot. So all of my switching can be done in either the SDI domain or the IP-based domain. So this collaboration with Evertz allows us to directly interconnect with the EXE IP-based routing system over 10 gig SFP fiber. With that plugged into the switcher, we now are part of that ecosystem. Now, one advantage that we've left is it's not a SDI or IP world. If you want, every single physical input can either be sourced from the SDI domain or from your IP domain. You're not trapped in one environment or the other. And the fact that we went with SFPs, it benefits us because now as the world progresses, when we go to 100 gig, these can be replaced, simply swap them in, and you don't have to replace an entire board. So thank you for taking the time to look at our Acuity production switchers. We really appreciate any chance we could get to interact with you. So if there's more information, you can go to the Acuity section of our website, and you can contact us at switchers@rossvideo.com. So thanks again.